On this video, we're going to be going over the ILS Niner in Opa-locka in Miami. We are going to be using JEP charts and we are flying a Cessna 172 G1000. These videos are designed for entertainment and provide you some sort of support for study at home. It's not meant to replace certified flight instruction. The way to use these videos is watch them. Try to practice in your home simulator. This is getting you better prepared for your home lessons, for your flight lessons. And if you are struggling, you have to seek instruction from a certified flight instructor. All right, so now we are on the left downwind runway, Niner left. The G1000 is actually set up. We just loaded whatever we had in here. So originally we would be coming from a flight plan. The first thing we're going to do is load the ILS 9 left. I'm going to select procedure on the MFD, select approach. I'm going to select OPF. ILS 9 left, looks good. Vectors or a transition. In this case, it makes no difference. I'm going to select vectors. Vectors loads all the waypoints on the final approach course on this version of the G1000. Prior versions, we will make videos about them. We'll have only load the final approach fix and maybe a waypoint prior to a final approach fix. In this case, we're going to select vectors, minimums. We do have the local altimeter setting. We have 258, so we're going to round it off to 260. Go select enter. If we had a flight plan, which you would, you will have a loader activate. I will highly encourage you that you load it. In this case, I don't have that option, so I'm going to activate. I'm going to say yes. And now I'm going to select Okeni, and I'm going to extend the course by, actually, let me go over that. I'm going to push the FMS knobs on the MFD, big knobs to the left. I'm going to select the direct key and then scroll right. And now it's going to be 093. There we go, enter, enter. And now I have a extended centerline along the course. The prior to loading the approach, we should have gotten the ATIS. I'm just going to load the frequency, 25.9. And I'm going to make sure I have COM1 mic and COM2 so I can listen. At this point, we'd also be talking with Miami approach, which is 128.6. And I will expect tower to be coming up soon. So that's 134.67. It is important to note, the only reason I am dealing with the frequencies is because we're not coming in sequence on an actual approach. Meaning, if you were coming from Melbourne to Opa-locka, anywhere, you already be having all these frequencies in sequence. You will be getting your ATIS roughly about an hour out. You will be loading the approach. You will be doing all these things way ahead of time. You will not be doing them on a downwind leg. The reason why we're in a downwind leg is just to accelerate the process for this video. Now that we have the approach loaded and it's extended, we have the frequency set, we are going to unpause the simulator and start flying the approach, and I'll do everything. We already load it, I'm gonna check it, and then we'll brief it, we'll turn base, intercept final, and we'll have fun with this. I'm going to select autopilot, heading, altitude, and I'm going to select 2,000 feet. And now we can unpause the simulator. I'm going to set about 2,200 RPM for our purposes today. I'm going to select CDI. I'm going back to GPS. The reason I'm going back to GPS is because I extended that course. I also have on my bearing pointers, I'm going to press PFD. Bearing 1 is set to NAV1, and bearing 2, and here I'm just going to show you, is going back to GPS. Okay. Now that we're pretty much abeamed the airport, I'm going to decrease my power slightly. Now I'm going to check the information. We're doing the ILS 9 left in Opa-locka. Okeni is going to be across at 1,600. The final approach or the glide slope intercept is SASBO 1,600. Then is the missed approach. I'll come back up here. And then it's going to be climbing straight ahead. on a heading of 093 to Janus and hold on the 069. It is important to always check the database. The database is current about 99% of the time, but there's always that 0.1% that I personally have seen the hold being off from what is on the database to what's on the chart. So now let me get some situation awareness. So we still gonna be at Beam SAS, but we still probably got a few more minutes before ATC turns us left. I would also, you have to check the NOTAMs. Notice that we do have, there are NOTAMs that are affecting this flight. And if I will be flying this in real life, I will be taking a very close look at this NOTAMs for today's purposes. We're in the simulator. So let me coordinate that the rudder was just got a little bit stuck there. That's why it was flying crooked. Now that that's fixed, now we have the ADAS, we have the NOTAMs, we checked the approach, we loaded, we checked it. Now let's brief it. We are going to fly the ILS 9 left. It checks 21-1 effective January 27. Especially if you have a multi-crew environment, you'll be comparing those numbers in JEP charts with the other pilot. The approach frequency is 110.5. Final approach course is 093, which is set. SASPA 1600. We do have conditions. We do have the current altimeter setting is 258 minimums. We already bought 260. Touchdown elevation is 8 feet. If we have the approach lighting system inside, once we get to minimums, we can descend 100 feet above touchdown elevation, which is going to be at 108. The notes here where it says caution, those you have to read prior for you to embark on this flight and actually highlight anything that applies. If you have time, welcome to read them, but this is not part of the approach because they actually will determine if you're legal for this approach or not. MSA from the quadrant we're coming is 2,100. Once we cross SASPO, we are descending down to 260. Notice that that 480 and SALTA is actually for one is if we're 500 when we're using Miami International Altimeter. And sometimes that note is also for the localizer. And I know that SALTA is used for the localizer because it's not on the database. Okay, just want to make sure where we are. We need 3/4 miles. The ADAS, we're assuming it's information. Alpha is 200-foot ceilings. Actually, 250, just to make it keep it simple. 250-foot ceilings and 3/4 mile visibility. In case we have to go miss, make sure forward, throttles forward, disengage the autopilot, bring the nose up 10 degrees. Notify the tower, engage nav, make sure that they did unsuspend, make sure that we are on the GPS, and we are going to fly the missed approach, and we're gonna set 2,000, ensure we have 2,000 for the missed approach altitude. Somewhere along this line, ATC will tell us to turn left heading 180. And now notice how it came up with the India Oscar Papa Foxtrot. That means the G1000 system did identify the frequencies for us. Missed approach, we already briefed that it's gonna be straight ahead. Then at 093, we're gonna intercept and we're gonna be to Janus and hold. One other important thing is we're gonna be configuring for the approach 2 miles prior. Now, notice prior to this, I extended the center line. Now I can see that we're gonna be intercepting between Olcani and SASPO. So on the MFD, I'm gonna push the FMS knobs, highlight SASPO, menu, activate lag, and now I'm gonna select enter. The reason why we're doing this is because the flight management system needs to be sequenced in order for us to have it ready, not only for DME waypoints, measurements, but also for the missed approach. So now I'm gonna be waiting, the bearing 2 pointer is showing about 130 course. I'm gonna wait until it's about 120 because that's normally when ATC is gonna give us the heading to intercept. I'm also wanna keep my speed about 120. Outside temperature is 5 degrees. If this we will be in real IMC, I'd actually will turn the PDOT heat on, which I'll do that right now. And that's the outside temperature, something a lot of pilots do overlook, especially when it comes to PDOT heat, icing conditions. So there we go. Now we're going to make a left turn 130. We're going to descend at 1600. And this, we are assuming that are the ATC frequencies or let me correct that, ATC instructions. And they will tell us to say turn left heading 130, descend maintain 1,600, maintain 1,600 until established, clear for the ILS 9 left. So there it is, 9 left. I'm going to select APR for approach mode, localizer heading, autopilot vertical speed 600, 1,600, glide slope. It's on standby. I know the localizer and glide slope are in standby because they're white. 2.9 miles, ITC would already have us on course, so I probably turn a little bit too early. For our purposes, it works. Real life, they would have given us, I think that they do have a minimum distance by the time you have to be established on course. I can actually request an amendment heading. Let me go 140, just so I can expedite that, intercept the course. Course is alive. If you had to deviate like I did for that 140 heading, do let ATC know. The reason I just did that is because we don't have an ATC given an ATC given inspector, so therefore I just had to modify it for the video. We are inside the final approach, inside 2 miles. I'm already slow, 180. I'm actually gonna delay my flap retraction until about 1 mile, which, and then I'm gonna be conducting my landing checklist. 1.4 miles. Glide slope alive. 1 mile, 10 degrees of flaps. I make sure I come in with some power just so I can try to stay about 90. In landing checklist, gas is on the fullest tank, fuel selector valve is on both. Undercarriage is fixed, mixture is full rich, props are fixed. Seat belts are good on the left. Here it comes. And somewhere along the lines, they're gonna tell us to switch over to tower. I'm monitoring the autopilot, make sure it does intercept the glide slope. Glide slope intercept, set missed approach altitude, which is 2000. One thing a lot of people forget is to pull the power back. I also was a little bit guilty of that when we level off. Actually, that's why the speed was 80. In the 80 range when we level off, because I did forget to add a little bit of power. Like you're gonna see on the videos, the reason is gonna be is because I'm multitasking here. And that's where the simulator is a great place to learn, is because we're not moving and we can actually have these conversations. Then ATC will tell us to switch over to tower, 13467. And now I'm gonna load 120.2 on standby. I'll check my speed. I'm slow. Now I'm going to be flying about 75 knots. It's going to be my target speed, 1,000 feet above minimums. Up like a tower, Cessna 106 Air Tango, ILS 9 left. That will give us a landing clearance as well. There it is, 70. And I want to be about 75. Notice also one thing, I am hovering my thumb over the autopilot disengage. I can actually tell there's a little bit of turbulence here, which is not uncommon for Florida. Reduce my power gently. On the approach speed, you can fly a little bit faster if you want to. You can fly at 80, 85. Just be cognizant that you will have to bleed that energy, and flaps is not an option. It's because if you're breaking off at 250 foot ceilings and half a mile and 3/4 mile visibility, you don't have the visual reference. 500 minimums. Also, if you get too slow with flaps 10, your nose starts pitching up, your angle of attack, your attitude starts getting high, which is not ideal because then you can stall the airplane. In this case, I can tell that 75 is a good target speed for this airplane. 400. We are clear to land, mixture forward in case we make a miss, mixture forward, throttle forward, autopilot disengage, pitch the nose up 10 degrees. 300. 200. approaching minimums. Minimums, no runway, autopilot disengage, mixture, throttle comes forward. I'm going to press toga, there's my 10 degrees. I'm gonna press control wheel steering. Roll pitch, I'm going to select nav. Suspend is out. El Palenque Tower, Cessna 106 here, Tango, missed approach. I'll pitch for those 10 degrees, get with the command bars, clear of all obstacles, flaps up. Heading leg, GPS pitch, altitude select 2000, and they will tell us to switch over to departure, which now I will switch back to 128.6. And I will call them. Miami departure, 106 here, Tango missed approach, 9 left, 1000 to go. Cool. I will pause the simulator. Notice that I did make mistakes. One of the mistakes was on that level off. I didn't have power, so I slowed down all the way to 85 knots or so. Could have been a little bit better, more proactive on my throttle. Also, when I'm gonna blame it on multitasking here, I misjudged the heading. There's a reason why I'm a pilot and not an air traffic controller. But overall, we were within standards. Speed control could have been a little bit better. And that's the important thing when you're doing this training is to just know what you did well, what you could have improved, and make sure that you make the corrections for future flights. We have other videos that are going to be coming on for different airports here in the Florida area. We're also going to have videos in Europe, Latin America. Stay tuned and follow our channel.